Hello everybody and welcome to the HTFRA 90s Are All That Cup Series. We're here live at the classic North Wilkensboro Speedway for the first Union 400. Starting on the pole today is Maxwell Clockworth, on the outside is Abby Sachs. And we have an all slim fast second row. We have Leia Walker in third and the fourth, and George Rourke, her teammate, in the fourth spot in the 18. Starting fifth is the 90 of Bill Flickinger and sixth of the 42 Madison Denhart. 7th of 25 of Corey Decker, and 8th is the 17 Madoka Tsunge. 9th is the 20 Michael White, and rounding up the top 10, the 01 of Alex Ragu. And now without further ado, let's hear those famous words in motorsports.
Drivers, start your engines!
And here we go, cars are rolling off the track. 25 laps here at the classic North Wilkensboro Speedway. And it's one of the last races we'll do at this track for the foreseeable future, as it's been removed from the peak Pokemon Cup Series Season 3 schedule. So we'll enjoy a while at last in this short track of Wilkensboro. So here we go, folks. Clockworth leads for 25 laps here in the classic Wilkensboro Speedway. The green flag is out. Oh, we have a wreck below. Someone just took them on the bottom, and the caution is out. And I don't know if the caution is out now. Yes, no, it's not. It's not out. I'm surprised. Oh boy, Andre Cave, he had a bad run. There's Madison Denhart. Now the caution is out. I guess that was the reason the caution came out. Clockworth has to slow down a bit if he has to keep his lead, and he will keep the lead. Wow, what happened back there with these guys? Let's see. So here's what happened below. Oh wow, that started back. It started way back. John McNamara was the cause of it. And now, there. Look at that. Here we go. They were going three wide here. Not a good way to do three wide. There's Chris Grant getting clipped, and there's John McNamara getting a piece as well. Dakota Erickson just was not at the right place at the time, and he gets a piece. But what was up with Andre Cave back there? Let's see what happened. Ooh, not a good hit as he gets clipped by the 19 of Eli Sachs, as I apologize for that little mistake there. There's Andre Cave, and his luck has just not been great since he had won the Daytona 500, and he gets clipped by the 19. And he didn't cause a caution, he didn't go for a full spin, so that was why he did not cause it. And finally we saw Madison Denhart getting hit as well, so we'll see what happened here. And that was the one that was the clipping. That was the one we saw getting someone clipped. Oh, there was Madison Denhart. There's a 25. I think that's Chris Grant. No, that's Corey Decker. Corey Decker decks the 42 in the pits. And yet that's probably why that did not cause a caution, as it was took place on pit road. So it took place in the pits. So I guess that was why there was no caution back there. And that was why we have a spin and another one with Pichu. The last winner of Darlington, there's the 33, there's the 0 getting clipped, there is the 4, Dylan Young, there's 0, and there's 33, they all get clipped, yikes, Dylan Young is clipped, yeah, wow, what a wreck back there, and that would have been really dangerous for these drivers since it's a short track. They're actually very close to them. And I'm surprised they're playing it safe. And they're going to take a little while in the pits, as it's going to be a long caution period. Many drivers retired, and it was Andre Cabe, Dakota Erickson, Chris Grant are retired. Corey Decker, Madison Denhart, Dylan Young are a lap down. I wonder how they'll be controlling the lap cars. And the lap cars are going to be on the bottom, so this is going to set up a very, very interesting restart here at North Wilkensboro, as there's cars on the bottom. Those are lapped cars. It's going to be very interesting to see how they take the restart, as Maxwell Clockworth, despite being congested by lapped cars, has the lead here at North Wilkensboro. Here we go. The green flag will be out. And the green is out again here at North Wilkensboro. Clockworth had no problem passing these lapped cars. But the 25, he's actually putting up a little bit of a fight. Leo Walker gets held up by the 42. Oh boy. That's going to allow the 90 of Bill Flickinger to pass for second. It's a close race, and now Clockworth using the lapped cars to his advantage, helping them pull away, as now the 90's got a lot of work ahead of him in order to even have a shot at the lead. And it's still all about the lap cars. The 90 is not even close to the 42, and that's going to affect him a lot. Bob Fergus moves up to the top five. And now he's eyeing Leia Walker for that third spot. And now we have a wreck with the eight. And I think, yeah, that is the eight of, forgot his name. Theo Stiegel. Caution, I think, is out. No, caution's not out. We stay green. Oh, boy. We'll get to Theo Stiegel in a moment as soon as we get another caution, which is not happening at this lap. And now Winn-Dixie's 98 is leading us 13 to go here at North Wilkensboro. He's having an easy, comfortable lead after he passed all lap cars, but he's got to keep his eyes set on Bill Flickinger. Flickinger just passed Denhart, and now only the 25, Corey Decker, is in his way, but Madison Denhart, she's not giving up without a fight. She passes Clockworth, even though it's not for second. She's not on the lead lap. She's still racing like she is. And that's not helping the 90 at all. It is helping a lot in the 98, though. Still 11 laps to go and still has the lead. There's another caution. The lap cars won't play a factor, hopefully. But there hasn't been one yet. There has been only one so far. And Clockworth has a lead with 10 to go. It is now 10 to go at North Wilkensboro. There's Theo Stiegel, a lap car. We'll see if it plays a factor in the 98's lead. Now we have about 9 to go at North Wilkensboro. Clockworth has been having the lead all day since he took the pole. And he's been having the lead so far. Nothing stopping him so far, but the only one stopping is Theo Stiegel. And there's the 51 is in the pits. That's Jacob Cook. And I think he might have caused a caution. No, he's not. Uh-oh. No caution so far, and there is damaged cars. That's going to play a factor in his lead if he comes up to it. There you see in his roof, it's a little bit close. They're a little closer now. Getting a little close to that, and I'm not sure if they're going to reach it. But he's going to reach it. If he holds on, this will be his first win in a TA2 league for Maxwell Clockworth. There you see the 51 go in the pits magically. Damage was too much for him, so I guess we're not going to look back at it. I guess he hit the wall or something. 6 to go for the 98. And the 90 has no shot at him unless the 98 blows up in the middle of the track. 5 to go here at North Wilkensboro, and he's dying for a caution so that he can breeze by this field. 4 to go here at North Wilkensboro for the 98 of Maxwell Clockworth. That Winn-Dixie machine is running. 4 to go for the 98. The next lap car he has to worry is Theo Stiegel, but he's not catching up to him. He's way far behind Stiegel, so not sure if that's going to play a factor again. 3 to go here at North Wilkensboro. Nothing much to say here, except Maxwell Clockworth is just dominating. That's all we could say for now. 2 to go here, and I guess this is why that the Pole 1 Cup Series is not returning to this track for Season 3. And the fact that only 40 drivers exactly can be fit on this track. So I'm glad to have only a 40 driver field so that I didn't have to miss one driver out. Here we go, white flag is out for Maxwell Clockworth, and he's got no challenge between him. White flag is out. Unless if he has problems, he's going to breeze by to the victory. And he'll not pit, and off the final turn, in dominating fashion, Maxwell Clockworth gets the win at North Wilkensboro for his first TA2 League victory. Congrats to Maxwell Clockworth, a dominating run for him from start to finish. Bill Flickinger, Bob Fergus, Leia Walker, Michael White make up your top 5. Ben Cannon, Sam Young, Abby Sachs, George Rourke, Scott Commons, your top 10. And here's the rest of the field below. Pretty tame day here at North Wilkensboro as Max Clockworth in dominating fashion gets the win. And the standings heading into Sonoma. Bob Fergus, your new leader, by 19 points over Matt Taylor. Eli Sachs, 3rd. Bill Flickinger, 4th. Pichu, 5th. Alan Smith, 6th. Michael Wright, 7th. Shane Ray, 8th. Manny Denhart, 9th. Andre Cape, 10th. And that's the drivers from 1st to 20th here below. And here's the ones below 21st to 40th. And as you can see, I was able to fit all 40 drivers in the track. I thought I wasn't able to in North Wilkensboro, but I was. Apologize for moving around. Here's one more look at the top bottom 21. So that'll do it here from North Wilkensboro. Next race is Infineon Raceway for the Banquet 300. I know it's a short track, but I hope to make things interesting for you guys so that short tracks don't become boring. So anyway, hope to see you guys at Infineon, and we'll see you later.